Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. My name is Chowda Panarayan and I work for New Circle Procurement in this building in level 10. The growth of a child, a human being from birth, has been always fascinating to me. What we do, a newborn child, it always expresses its wants and desires in an uncontrolled way. And the challenge of the parents is to condition the child so that it is more fitted into the society. I was looking for a word that would describe how unpolished the behavior of the children when they're not controlled and when they're not being given a good brought-up. Today I have learned incontinent is a word for me to use because that's how I was when I was young. It takes years for me to move away from that situation to become more polished.
About your home life, which you would like to improve and why?
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. One thing about my home life. I'm generally a task-oriented person and I prioritize. If there are a lot of cleaning work to be done, I would like to volunteer myself to do the cleaning so that it frees up my wife's time and she's able to spend some time with my daughters. But often that is not appreciated. Why? Because they don't want me to do the cleaning. They want me to join the conversation. So that is one aspect I need to change myself. And it's very difficult because for me, things should appear in order, speak and dream, in place. If it is not the case, then I don't get relaxation. I'm not able to enjoy the time. That's the reason I immediately dive into those kind of activities and make sure, particularly the kitchen is very clean, but often at the detriment of my wife's.
Thank you.
I joined the meeting already, the word power has started, so I haven't noticed what the chairman spoke. But thank you to Mila for delegating this role halfway through. So I'll try to imagine what Mark might have spoken in his inaugural address. He probably would have welcomed you all, probably stated the apologies, and then he started the events. He has done very well as a chairperson. There was long, warm, cardiality.
Room arrangement?
The room arrangement has been done speak and span. Everything in order made it very easy for the meeting to start. So it set the tone for a very, very good meeting. Congratulations to all those organizers who have done. Perhaps Mark.
No, that was a lot more than me.
Right.
Thank you.
A teamwork always produces more energy. As a chairperson, he was able to go through the items and give some sense of direction and control. He was very warm. He was able to make some filling statements as well between the items. For this role, if you want to practice to be a chairman, it requires a little bit more or less of informality and more of formalness. That means we have to really act like a chairman, sitting and not making colloquial or conversational style of statements. And bringing a sense of seriousness, they will enhance the impact of the chairman's role, I believe. So the chairman can be sitting, he doesn't have to stand during the proceedings, and the chairman can go through each item. Particularly with where certain things were missed out, there is no need to say that, oh, I'm sorry, I missed out these things, and just go through the items. But more important thing is, this requires more practice. Whoever does the chairman's role, they need to do this often so that the seriousness comes into the role and less of conversational style of words come in our company, in general. Word power. Jade, very good thought has gone into it, very good research, a new word, it enabled everybody to expand their vocabulary. Very valuable word she has chosen today. And allowed everybody to speak on the word and give a very good report at the end. Very clear voice, very loud, and people are able to understand what she talks. Toastmaster, again done by Mark, multiple roles he has done. He had collected the background, that was very good of the Toastmaster to have come prepared with all those background information, saying the timings. It may be a good idea for the Toastmaster to include the objectives of the speech also instead of delegating to the evaluator. It just fits in very well, ties well, comes out well, as one role, start to finish the Toastmaster role, instead of in between delegating it to an evaluator. In the worst situation where a Toastmaster doesn't have objectives, they can always leave those items to the evaluator to be covered in their evaluation speech. We also gain a little bit of time. But otherwise, Mark generally has got a very affable type of personality that creates the rapport very easily with the audience. Table Topics Master, Angela, very clear, well thought out, has come prepared very well. And I like the smile she gives all the time, even when selecting her prey. And she enjoys more when the prey is twitching. She would make a very good magistrate who has to give a death sentence. She would do it with smile. Very friendly, very clear. And there was a situation where there was some confusion with one of the evaluators, tabletop evaluator, and she took the blame on herself. Sorry, it was my fault. And that speaks of a great personality. On the whole, it was executed with a lot of professionalism. Table Topics Evaluator Odds, Crystal, very warm, very friendly, very measured, so that people can hear what she is talking. And she uses some simple but vivid words, like succinct, clear. But in the evaluation, she straight away started with how the person, the table topic speakers, were trying desperately to meet the timings or to rush to the timings. It may be a good idea for the evaluator to start with the good points first and then come in the points for improvement later. Table Topics Evaluator or Events Evaluator, Shubhangi. Very clear, very, very loud, lot of gestures, lot of animation that really kept us hooked. Great evaluation, particularly on my role as the tabletop speaker that I was, what was it, something you said?
Clean free.
I think my wife would have enjoyed the evaluation more. Now, points for improvement for both the evaluators is that try to avoid using the first person saying, and secondly, looking at the person and then giving the evaluation, because the evaluation is meant for everybody. Everybody has to learn from that experience. So the evaluation is given to the full flow and not to the individual. So in that respect, the first person is not recommended. Otherwise, it was a great evaluation. Word power, I already covered. The motion, the chairperson controlled it very well. He gave the opportunity to the person to speak on that issue, and he did not restrict from being canvassed on that notion. He allowed a few people to speak, and he adjourned that we'll have to, he took the control back in ensuring that the meeting was on time. That was very good. On the timings by Mila, very accurate timings. It helps all of us to know where we have to restrict, where we have to be clear, at the same time where not to elaborate too much and where to synthesize. It's a great point that Mila has covered by giving those activity plans. Once again, it was a great meeting, even though the number of people were very less. It's again another quality meeting of this club, and I commend you all, particularly the chair. This was